Council meetings are long and boring. Wouldn't it be great if they were short and unboring? This is why I have invented the 5-minute meeting. All right. Ashland City Council meeting of September 1st. This one, and this one, not here. Don't know why. This one's in charge. All right, so city attorney read the mayor's statement saying that regarding the ordinance allowing cops to ask for your name, that should have lots of more discussions and meetings and data collection before voting on it. So let's delay that vote. And then this guy goes, hey, I move we make April 5th the day that we vote on this stop and identify ordinance. And this one goes, this ordinance is all the agitators' fault anyway, so let's vote. And they all agreed, and they passed it. It passed. All agreed. April 5th, they're going to talk about that. But then this one goes, hey, by the way, now can we go back and then add requirements for the police to tell us when they should maybe talk to us before then? And then he goes, oh, yeah, that's a good idea. Let's ask the police what they think first and let us tell them what we should do. And then this one goes, hey, the mayor proclaims that the first week of September is home inventory week. So call your insurance agent. And then the Climate Policy Commission report began. It was like 20 minutes of guy figuring out how to do Zoom. And then the climate guy finally said, hey, so we do SEEP stuff, and the pandemic has slowed down our work. And on bill, utility outreach, state building codes, blah, 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 building electrification. And this guy goes, subcommittees aren't happening, right? He went, yes, that's a good try. That is correct. Oh, my God. That was pretty dull. And then public forum, a live public forum, for real. It's back on. There's some guy named Marty says he lives up on the Ashland Mine Road, and it's really brushy up there, and 100 families would have to evacuate during a fire down one road. And so that's scary to him. And he goes like, hey, we should look at that. And the city says, oh, yeah, that's a pretty good idea. And then city administrators report. So the Jackson County 5 Fire Department said, and the city are looking at sharing more responsibilities. And the city utility bill disconnection policy, which is some social problem, social internet question issue. And the city said, oh, we're trying to work with people who can't pay and hooking them up with the state and the county COVID funds. And then the city administrator said, I love my staff. And this one said, hey, how is the new public forum info being communicated? And the city guy went, oh, it's the same as always. He said it like that's, in a great way, and which we all know means being done terribly. And then the consent agenda came, and then this guy goes, hey, tell people about the new finance director we're hiring. And the city administrator said, oh, the candidate is great. And this one said, she is a financial angel. And this guy said, I move to approve the consent agenda and that candidate. And they all approved it. And then the city guy brought the final presentation for approval. And they all agreed and they approved it. What was it? Oh, that's funny. They never said. They did not say what it was. But there's a thing. It's the, I'll tell you, it was the Alicia Street Cottage Housing Project. And they denied the appeal. And that means that it allows a 12 cottage housing project to move ahead. But I never bothered explaining that to people because you're just citizens in the audience, whatever. And then the fire department had a final proposal. The city is going to hire an outside company to tell us how much our ambulance service costs. So the fire chief brought a final document listing all the things he thinks that these company, whoever does this study, should look at. And everyone liked the list. It went over pretty good. And then, social equity and racial justice. This is a new once a month thing that's gonna happen once a month. And so there is a public forum. Somebody zoomed in, a lawyer for justice lady, and she said, we need to stay on this process and engage the police and test the data. And this one said, I got a lot of written stuff on this. And the city guy goes, oh, well, I can put it up on the screen. And she goes, words. I'm going to put it on screen. Juneteenth celebration. Hey, where are we with that? And the city guy went, now that's going to cost $55,000 to $60,000 in overtime right off the top. And she goes, and we're also talking to the state about MLK Day next year, right? And then this guy goes, hey, I'm I'm going to talk to the Arts Commission, and Dead Indian Memorial Road name thing is still a huge problem. And this guy goes, hey, I totally agree. We need to push the county commissioners candidates that are coming up for the next election to consider that issue. And then this guy moved on and said, I want to propose we postpone the citizen budget committee appointments to the next meeting. So they did that. And then the Ashland airport master plan, the city beard commissioner, got a big beard, said history of the airport, projection of airplane traffic in the future, and lots of airplane info. And these two went, wow, who knew that airport master plans could be so interesting? And I must have slept through the interesting parts. But all approved. And then there's a new union contract for clerical employees, and the human resources lady said the union is paying more for health care, so that's cool. And this guy goes, we approve that 2-year contract for those people, and all players. And then there's a union contract for electrical employees. And the city attorney jumped in on this one and said, oh, we only have 16 employees there, but these workers are super hard to get, so we're gonna pay them 5% more for the first year, and then 1% for the second year. And he spent a lot of time rationalizing and making excuses for this contract. So methinks he doth rationalize too much. He must have lost big time in the negotiations. But she jumped in and said, hey, electrical companies are throughout the West are grabbing up linemen, so it's worth the pay more to have a good electrician. So that was passed again. And then another non-union employee agreement was agreed to, and the non-union employees agreed to no regular pay increases for the next 2 years and more health insurance contributions, and that's going to save the city over $200,000 for 2 years. And that was passed. And then this one said, hey, realtors have a wildfire grant to teach home sellers and buyers about wildfire and the houses they buy. And this guy goes, hey, go down to the railroad district and check out that Black Lives Matter display on the fence. It is awesome. Oh, nice way to end. That's the end. You're welcome.